simple hobby, but I write for the team.
Decks can be blocked either with a shield or a weapon, but shields are much more effective. Welcome to the stream, now we are gonna play. Welcome to the stream, now we're gonna play. Welcome to the stream, now we're gonna play some Skyrim. And we're gonna give them a fucking mustache. Oh, bum ba da dum ba ba da 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 da.
Alduin, we heard the Dragonwren shout from here.
That's good.
You defeated him?
Yeah.
I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after your battle.
Oh, yeah.
We are not warriors. What is over...
You misunderstand our authority.
I see. The dragon will lead you to Alduin, but without the Jarl's help. Parthenax has made the decision to help you. This is the road we have to walk. Even the Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems.
Yeah, because you all blow.
Tell Ulfric and General Tullius that the Greybeards wish to speak to them. We will see if they still remember us. Deliver the message to the warring part. The old tales say that he can travel into Sovngarde to devour the souls of the dead. You must find out how he does this before he regains his strength and returns.
Deal. Let's fucking do this, mate.
Alright, I'm gonna go here, and then I'm gonna go there to talk to Kings. Yes, master.
Oh yeah, look at me. I am ready. Draedric princes are like godlike creatures being inhabited by the plane of Oblivion. Most are considered evil, forcing their worships to build a shrine for civilized people, places.
Yes, quite indeed, master. Yes, indeed.
One, two, three. I think I'm synced.
Never should have come here.
Hey, someone, what are you doing? Ah! On the big one.
I'll give you permission to attack them.
A fight. Is someone there?
I wonder why they're mad at him, though.
Algrif won't give us a straight answer.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
Don't be so sure of that.
Only the foolish or the courageous approach a Jarl without summons.
The Empire's putting a great deal of pressure on Whiterun.
Is that so? Yes. You were with us at Helgen. Destined for the chopping block, if I'm not mistaken. A fair point. Well, you've come to the right place. I'm always looking for able fighters. Seems we're all... So long. And what would you have? Speak with Galmar. He'll size you up. It's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want? I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. And the dragon attacks are a growing plague.
Yes.
But the political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself will be there. Alduin, the world eater of song and legend. If that's true, well, it changes the situation, doesn't it? Even Tullius may be forced to talk sense in the face of such a threat. Yes, I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim with his tail between his legs.
If he's not with us, he's against us.
He knows that. They all know that.
How long are you going to wait?
You think I need to send Borgruf? I'll come to your council, but I doubt any good will come of it. Taking his city and leaving him in disgrace would make a more...
The Stormcloaks are finding victory across the land.
So we're ready to start this war in earnest, then.
Soon.
I still say you should take them all out like you did Dead King Torig.
Torig was merely a message to the other Jarls. Whoever we replace them with will need the support.
I'm not much of a strategist, but Lord Ulfric listens to my counsel all the same.
Things hinge on Whiterun.
If you have any news of the Western Borders, take it to Ulfric immediately.
The people are behind you.
Many, I fear, still need convincing.
Then let them die with their false kings.
We've been soldiers a long time. We know the price of freedom. But people are still weighing things in their hearts.
What's left of Skyrim to wager?
They have families to think of.
How many of their sons and daughters follow your banner? We are their families.
Well put, friend. Tell me, Galmar, why do you fight for me?
I'd follow you into the depths of oblivion. You know that.
Yes, but why do you fight? If not for me...
Terrible shame what happened to those women.
I'll die before elves dictate the fates of men. Are we not one in this?
I fight for the men I've held in my arms, dying on foreign soil. I fight for their wives and children whose names I heard whispered in their last breath. I fight for we few who did come home, only to find our country full of strangers wearing familiar faces. I fight for my people, impoverished to pay the debts of an empire too weak to rule them, yet brands them criminals for wanting to rule themselves. I fight so that all the fighting I've already done hasn't been for nothing. I fight because I must.
Your words give voice to what we all feel, Ulfric. And that's why you will be High King. But the day words are enough will be the day when soldiers like us are no longer needed.
I would gladly retire from the world, were such a day to dawn.
Aye, but in the meantime, we have a war to plan.
Fuck. All right, that's one down. Bark, 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 bark. Bark, 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 doggy, doggy, bark, 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 dog, 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 dog. Doggy, doggy, dog, dog, bark, barky, dog, dog, bark, dog, bark, 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 bark,
Wait. I know...
Yes, I am Dragonborn. You might know me by a little name called Go Fuck Yourself. Yes, indeed. Yes, yes, yes.
I'm telling you, Ulfric's planning an attack on Whiterun.
He'd be insane to try. He does. I remember you. You were at Helgen. Speak to Legate Rikka. I suspect we could use someone like you. Good.
That's not what my scouts
speak with Legate Rikka, the Greybeards.
Every day more joy.
What do those old hermits want with me?
Dawnstar and Winterhold support him.
Why, there's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor. They are getting to be a problem, but I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons. My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that, dragons or no dragons. I'll be the judge of that. Besides, by all reports, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as much as we are from these dragon attacks. Fair enough. We're driving the Stormcloaks back well enough at the moment, but we're already overstretched. That's what comes of trying to win a war with a bare handful of legions. If the Emperor would just give me the reinforcements I've requested. Most of the Legion is tied down on the border with the Aldmeri Dominion. The Emperor can't afford to risk weakening Cyrodiil's defenses. From the Imperial City, our war here is just a sideshow, an interlude before the main event against the Thalmor resumes. Yes, yes, fine, I'll come to this Greybeard Council. For all the good it will do. It's not a cause, it's a rebellion.
Call it whatever you like, General. The man's going to try to take Whiterun.
Jarl Balgruuf.
Balgruuf refuses the Legion's right to garrison troops in his city. On the other hand, he also refuses to acknowledge Ulfric's claim.
Well, if he wants to stand outside the protection of the Empire...
Wait, I know you.
Ulfric pillages city.
General.
You people and your damn Jarls.
Sir, you can't force a Nord to accept help he hasn't asked for.
If Ulfric's making a move for Whiterun, then we need to be there to stop him. Draft another letter with the usual platitudes, but this time share some of your intelligence regarding Ulfric's plans. Embellish if you have to.
Sheathe
yes,
your
sir.
Weapons and come quietly.
You Nords and your bloody central honor.
Order of the Yarl, stop right there. Everything here appears to be in order. You can move along now. Be careful.
I hit the wrong button. Fuck! Zethanar is a god of work and comments. He has a shrine in the Temple of Divines in Solitude. Sweet. But yeah, this week is very strange.
I'm telling you, Ulfric's planning an attack on Whiterun.
I remember you. You were at Helgen. Speak to Legate Rikka. I suspect we could use someone like you. Good. He'd be... Speak with, like, the Greybeards. Why, there's nothing to... They are getting... My job is to quell this rebellion. I'll be the judge of that. Fair enough. That's what comes of trying to win a war with the bear. Most of... From the Imperial City are... Yes, yes,
that's
fine.
Not what
I'll
my
come
scouts
to this
report,
Greybeard
sir.
Council.
Every day
for
more
all
join
the
his
good
cause.
It will do.
Riften, Dawnstar, and Winterhold support him.
It's not a cause.
Where's these vampires coming from?
The wolves of Skyrim are feral savage beasts that hunt and take down packs and prey available, be it a man or animal. Animal or man, yes indeed, yes. And the world shall not commence until I die, and then I must do and thine, and then and deuce and dust and dust and this and KKK and all this other shit. Yes, 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 look at the wolfie, it could probably fuck your mother. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed.
The Greybeards have called a peace council at High Hrothgar.
No shit!
Do you believe it? Both Ulfric Stormcloak and General Tullius have agreed to go.
Fuck off. Whoa, that was weird. Alright, well... While I am here...
True, I may look the part of dashing swordsman, but I prefer the art of wit to that of warfare. Your typical solitude wench is like the city. A sharp mind. Speak.
As well. Oh. Brown and green skin dragons are usually weaker than the white or bronze skin cousins. Oh, okay. So green dragons are very weak. But they, I bet you they still have a fuck ton of health. So, dragons are still little bitches. I wonder where my horse is. Probably down at the stables. It's usually where it fast travels. Oh, what shall you do with the drunken sailor? What shall you do with the drunken sailor? What shall you do with the drunken sailor? Sailor, lie in the morning. Way, and up she rises. Way, and up she rises. Way, and up she rises. Her lie in the morning. Put him in the cabin with the captain. Oh, Lord. Put him in the cabin with the captain's daughter. Put him in the cabin with the captain's daughter. Put him in the cabin with the captain's daughter. Her lie in the morning. Way, and up. Way, hey, and up she rises early in the morning. Way, hey, and up. Way, hey, and up. Way, hey, and up she rises early in the morning. Doom, 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 way, hey, and up she rises early in the morning.
That does not sound like a fucking horse. That sounds like a damn pterodactyl. Really? I can't shout on a horse. Wow. Kinda stupid. Fire or frost, it is speaking in an ancient powerful tongue. The battle between two dragons is actually deadly verbal debate. So they're just talking to each other. Fuck you! Oh shit! It's a deadly verbal debate right here!
I know you.
Sweet Jesus. Horse.
Looks like you had no trouble. The effects have already been felt. The Ice Runner has failed to dock on time. Without the lighthouse, the Ice Runner will have swung wide of the western shoal and run aground on the eastern coast. My sister Dija will be at the wreck with our Black Blood Marauders. She knows to expect you. Get moving. I'll see if I can't delay any patrols out there.
Where the fuck am I going? Oh. Yeah, I'll fast travel here, see what happens. Oh. The Northern Maiden out of Windhelm is known to occasionally take passengers back and forth. Okay.
Your end draws near. You're... That was good work. Deja's in the hold of the ship. Go down two levels.
Need something?
My brother told me you were coming. I'm supposed to give you what you've earned. Ha! I'm afraid the loot's already been moved. You've been useful to the Black Bloods, though. You've earned a quick death. That's all you got.
What was that?
Is someone there? Here after all.
Oh yeah. You gotta fucking move, dude.
Is someone there? Come on! Come on! What are you doing?
Shit! Oh, you're a badass! cold, buddy? Wearing heavy armor or using heavy weapons will slow you down. Well, what are the odds? It's almost as if it's heavy or something. I only got an hour more to stream. For those of you that are wondering what that sound is, it is a vortex a cappella. It helps with your voice. You blow into it and it just shakes your entire lungs and it forces air through this small thing and it just works out your lungs basically. It's for like music. But yeah, you just blow into it. That's it. Simple as that.
Yes?
So somewhere on this boat, there should be a note somewhere saying exactly where they took it. I have a feeling it's on one of the dead bodies. Check one of these boys over here. Nope, nothing. Take all your shit. out. Find out where Jiro's bandits took the loot. I wonder where the loot has gone. Nothing up here with that symbol on it, though. Map. We're going on an adventure. I have an idea. Come on. Let's ride. Is fucked up and dead.
True. Thank you. Yeah.
You fucking helped a lot, didn't you? What the fuck is he shooting at?
Thank you.
Daedric, Prince of Power. He is fond of...
So, you've done it. The men of violence are gathered here, in these halls whose very stones are dedicated to peace. I should not have agreed to host this council. The Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters. Peace? I doubt it. They may put their weapons down for a moment, but only to gather strength for the next bloodletting. They are not yet tired of war. Far from it. You know the ancient Nord word for war? Season unending. And so it has proved. But regrets are pointless. Here we are. Take your seat at the council table, and let us see what wisdom we can find among these warriors of Skyrim.
Okay.
So, Arngeir, is it? You know why we're here. Are you going to let us in or not?
You're not invited here. You're not welcome here.
Why the fuck are you all black?
I've got your back. All right, what is it? What do you need? Can't do that. Sorry. Can't do that. Sorry.
Shit, you got that popo face.
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin. I hope that we have all come here in the spirit
of... insult us by bringing her to this negotiation? You're Chief Talos Hunter?
That didn't take long.
Diplomatic.
Hear, hear.
I have every right to be at this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
Please, if we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we will never get anywhere. Perhaps this would be a good time to get the Dragonborn's input on this matter.
By Ysmir's beard. The nerve of those Imperial bastards, eh? To think that I would sit down at the same table with that Thalmor bitch. Either she walks or I do. Maybe so, but bringing her here is a deliberate provocation. Talias needs to know I won't be pushed around. It feels like a mistake to me, but I'll bow to your judgment on this. But she is to observe, nothing more. We are not negotiating with her. Is that clear?
Ulfric, why so hostile? After all, it's not the Thalmor that's burning your farms and killing your sons.
She's supposed to be on our side?
You know exactly. No, not this time.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with the dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about. Unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't be able to resist.
We're here to arrange a temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more. I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Are you done? Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
Yes, let's get this over with.
Are we ready to proceed? Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, this council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar and do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace in Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Yes, let's get down to it. We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here, Ulfric? You dare to insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Elisif!
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss a truce.
Elisif, I said I'd handle it. Ulfric, you can't seriously expect us to give up Markarth at the negotiating table. You hope to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm sure Jarl Ulfric does not expect something for nothing.
Yes, that'd be entirely out of character.
What would the Empire want in return?
Wait, General, you don't intend to just hand over Markarth to that traitor?
This is how the Empire repays us for our loyalty?
Enough. First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time. You are a traitor to the Empire, and deserve a traitor's death. But I at least will negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Markarth is worth. The rift would help secure our communications with Cyrodiil, and threatened Ulfric's southern flank. You heard the man, Ulfric. We've made you a fair offer. Are you serious about these talks, or are you just here to posture?
I expected better from you, Dragonborn.
What?
I came here in good faith, and now it seems you held the Empire at every turn. As for you, General Tullius, I see now that Galmar was right. Talking to the Empire is just as useless as ever. If you think you can hold Markarth, you're as deluded as your Emperor when he signed away our freedom to Lothalmor. Skyrim will never again bow to your false Empire. Let's go, Galmar. I should have listened to you in the first place.
You always were a fool, Ulfric. You're no better at diplomacy than you are in the battlefield.
Stop! Are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreements? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Is he with you, Delphine? If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me, and I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned, the World Eater. Even now he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
A very pretty speech. But what does it have to do with a...
If he's right about Alduin, we both have just as much to lose here, Tullius. Remember that. Now, back to the matter at hand. Don't hand me a mug of sheep's piss and call it mead. These terms are still not acceptable.
I'm sure you have something in mind.
Damn right we do.
You surrender Hjalmarch to us, and take Idgrod Ravencrone with you. Sorli the Builder will take over as Jarl of Morthal.
Where do these demands stop, Ulfric? Do you expect me to surrender all of Skyrim?
It seems I have no choice but to let the Dragonborn decide. Although I'm starting to doubt your fairness. What say you, Dragonborn? Spoken like a true son of Skyrim. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
It seems we may have an agreement. Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, these are the terms currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces, Jarl Igmund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. The Stormcloaks will withdraw from the Rift, allowing Imperial troops unhindered access. Jarl Leyla Lawgiver will step down, and Maven Blackbriar will become the Jarl of Riften. Jarl March will be turned over to Ulfric, with Sorli the Builder assuming the Jarlship. You both agree to this?
The Sons of Skyrim will live up to their agreements, as long as the Imperials hold to theirs. What about you, Elisif? Are these terms to your liking? Speak up! I'm sure General Tullius is waiting to do your bidding.
I have nothing to say to that murderer. General, you've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. I appreciate your loyalty. The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it.
Come on, Dalmar. We have a lot of work to do.
Giving up Markarth is a heavy price for this truce, Dragonborn. I hope it was worth it.
I have to. I'm sorry. Save.
Groof, I assume you are familiar with the Dragonborn plan?
There's one more thing. We know it.
When you're ready to fight me for real.
To do my part. Yes, I'm ready to do my part. Word. And my men will help you spring this trap.
But the difficulty remains, how to lure a dragon.
Who's there? Right,
you. Oh. Somebody help.
Someone's being attacked!
Come on, I dare you.
Getting tired yet?
Well, that's...
Oh, Jesus!
You haven't overlooked that little detail, have you?
Yes, I'm ready to do my part.
I'm afraid there's a problem. A serious one. I've discovered who the Greybeard's leader really is. He's a dragon. The Blades. Justice demands that he die for his crimes. Until he is dead, I'm afraid my oath as a Blade prevents me from offering you aid and comfort.
Hmm.
good.
Word. And my men will help you spring this trap.
But the difficulty remains. How to lure a dragon?
Damn you!
At all.
Do the right thing. This is Parthenax not good. Deserves to die.
Ready to do my
I'm afraid there's a problem. A serious one. I've discovered who the Greybeard's leader really is. All well and good, but did you know that he was Alduin's chief lieutenant in ancient times? Responsible for terrible atrocities. It's true that his crimes are long in the past, but justice does not count the passage of years. The Blades have been hunting him for centuries, but he was protected by the Greybeards, and then the Emperors. Justice demands that he die for his crimes. Until he is dead, I'm afraid my oath as a Blade prevents me from offering you aid and comfort. Very good.
Say the word, and my...
I'm not killing Parthenax.
You spring this trap.
But the difficulty remains. How to lure a dragon to Dragon's Reach?
Well, that's an excellent question.
Do the right thing. Parthenax deserves to die.
Somebody help!
Die! Like the fight of a flea!
Yes, I'm ready to do my part. Just say the word.
We're counting on you to make this all worthwhile.
But I don't much like this truce.
How feels like a betrayal dragon to Dragon's Reach at all?
Well, that's an excellent question. You have... Overlook that little. Have you?
Ah, I believe I can be of help here. I anticipated the problem. While you were arranging this meeting, I was busy in the library of Skyhaven Temp, an unguessed trove of lost lore. But the important thing is that the Blades recorded many of the names of dragons they slew. Cross-referencing this with Delphine's map of dragon burial sites, I believe I've identified one of the dragons that Alduin has raised up. But don't you see? The names of dragons are always three words of power, shouts. By calling the dragon with a voice, he will hear you wherever he might be. He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful by nature and loath to refuse a challenge. Your voice in particular is likely to intrigue this dragon after your victory over Alduin. I think it's very likely that he will be unable to resist investigating your call. Ah, indeed. I'm no master of the voice, like these worthy gentlemen, but it is written here, in this scroll. Odavin, winged snow hunter, as I
would have been.
That could have gone worse. Now it's up to you to deliver.
These terms are satisfactory to my government. The truce is unlikely to last long in any case.
With a shield. Ooh, that is a nice shield, actually. I want Daedric armor.
I'm afraid
there's one more thing.
A serious one.
We know about Parthenax.
I discovered who the Greybeard's leader really is.
Not killing Parthenax. He taught me everything I know. He is me. I am him. Constipated as fuck. Oh.
Another wanderer.
We're ready, Dragonborn. Just say the word. Now, if you don't mind, I've got a city to keep. May the gods, as I promised, my men stand ready. The great chains are oiled. We wait on your word. My men know what to do. Make sure you do your part. I'm putting my city in your hands.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard.
Fuck off.
Vampire hunters or something. In the old fort near Riften.
Hey, Tim! How you doing? Hey, Bobbo.
Go ahead and call this dragon.
Let's get this over with. This was your crazy idea, huh?
We're ready when you are.
You bet. I don't know how you talked the Jarl into this. Let's get this over with. Let's get this over with.
Right! Thing!
Here. Yeah.
Let's get this over with.
Hear that?
Later, Tim.
Here alive.
Comes.
Steady.
Steady. Steady.
Hey, I use Dragon Rend, bitch. You come down here this instant.
Amid Kodav, caught like a bear in a trap. Zokfrinik, Zubonar, you went to a great deal of trouble to put me in this humiliating position. In Sir Alduin, no doubt you want to know where to find Alduin. Renik Vaza, an apt phrase. Alduin Boval. One reason I came to your call was to test your Thuum for myself. Many of us have begun to question Alduin's lordship, whether his Thuum was truly the strongest. Among ourselves, of course, Muni Mae, none were yet ready to openly defy him. Once Lord Croesus, innumerable pardons, I digress. He has traveled to Sovngarde to regain his strength, devouring the Silesiur, the souls of the mortal dead, a privilege he jealously guards. His door to Sovngarde is at Skuldafin, one of his ancient fanes high in the eastern mountains.
Okay.
Mindoran pa ok midove navarantil. I surely do not need to warn you that all his remaining strength is marshaled there. Zuulost ofan hinlan. Now that I have answered your question, you will allow me to go free? Serve you? No. Need id. If and when you defeat Alduin, I will reconsider. Croesus. There is one detail about Skuldafin I neglected to mention. Only this. You have the Thuum of a Dova. But without the wings of one, you will never set foot in Skuldafin.
Oh, shit.
Of course, I could fly you there, but not while imprisoned like this. Onikan Korav Gair Mirad. It is wise to recognize when you only have one choice. And you can trust me. Zu ni tarudis. Alduin has proven himself unworthy to rule. I go my own way now.
Okay.
Free me, and I will carry you to Skuldafin.
Incredible. Sir, you
I can't believe
no
You sure about that? Your funeral. Someone else is going to have to help you get him back in there again. I can't believe... You sure about that? You want to let that... Hey, when you make... Get ready to open the trap. This seems like a really bad idea to me.
Was nu? Dini dein Ruthi Astval. Are you ready to see the world as only a Dova can? Saran Uth, I await your command as promised. Are you ready to see the world as only a Dova can?
Yeah.
Zuk Brit Uth. Amativ. Mu Bo Kotin Stinselok.
Da 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 da!
That's fun.
This is as far as I can take you. Griffoth Akrin. I will look for your return. Or Alduin's.
Thank you.
Gold off him.
I could have gone over that easily. Look, there's even a road going up there. Trap the soul, that's cool. This one's a two. Boom. Hit it.
Oh my gosh, this is terrible.
Golgoth and Kosbinok.
I'm feeling I'm gonna have to be fighting a lot of dragons. Oh yeah. I'm good. I feel fine. I think that's fine. Could just stand up and run and read and hope and save. Thank you. absorb his soul. I think how you absorb a soul is like a kill it in 2 attacks or less. Some shit like that. Go up at.
information!
Shit went up there, see what happens. Nothing. Okay. Oop, something happened. I'm liking all these arrows around here. That arrow. Oh. Items. Potions. Stealth? Is there stealth around here? Stamina. Right in the knee. Waddle his way up here. Oopsies. Probably had some good shit on you. All I know is these archers loving their arrows. Take that. What time is it? Ooh, got 20 minutes. 20 minutes. Auto save. Finally, they come out of the woodworks. Oh. Archer duel. Thank you all so much for watching. I'm sorry I didn't get to talk as much as I wanted to today. But, yeah. Thank you all so much for joining me. I have to cut the stream a little early because I gotta go do some shit. Yeah. Thank you all so much. Hope you have a great day and... yes. DTFN.